Alright, you guys, this is going to be a review of the UTG Master Sniper. You may have noticed that I deleted the last review. That is because it was pretty bad. A lot of people requested that it was hard to see and stuff. So this is going to be a redo. If you are watching this and you watched my last review, just keep watching. This is going to be a lot more professional. So, yeah, this is a review of the UTG Master Sniper. I got this in OD Green. You can get it in OD Green, Black, ACU, or Desert Camo. I chose OD Green because I thought it looked the best. I was also debating on ACU, but I just thought this looked a little better. So this is a bolt action sniper, obviously. Very nice. Has a weight of 8 or 9 pounds. So the metal parts include the barrel, whole entire barrel, the bipod, which is included, the bolt, also has some rubber on it, but the bolt is metal and rubber, and the silver thing when you cock the bolt back, the sling mount right here on the stock, and the front sling mount, the safety, the trigger, and yeah, a lot of the internals too. So, the scope is also male, but this did not come with the gun. You have to buy a scope on your own. This is the NC Star 3x9x40 scope. You can get it on Amazon for $40. Really nice scope. And also the tactical rails male. I don't think I mentioned that. I might have, but I don't know. So this gun is very nice. I highly recommend it. The safety is located right here by next to the bolt. So right now it's off safe. You can pull the trigger, and then when you put it on, you flip it where the red circle is, and that means it's on safe. So you can't pull the trigger. So the safety is really nice, right next to the bolt, and the stock is really awesome. It has a textured grip right here. Very comfortable. Has a rubber butt pad right here. That's rubber butt pad. So also has some texture on the side right here, next to the barrel. So the trigger has a very easy pull. Feels really good. It's metal. So this is the magazine right here. It comes with two magazines. Each hold 25 rounds. So this is the mag. I already have a mag inside the gun. So you have to press this button right here, and it doesn't automatically eject. So you have to put your two fingers right here, and it slips out. And here it is. They each hold 25 rounds, which is really good. And put the mag back in. You gotta put the mag in forward, and then just push it in. Makes a nice click. So yeah, it's good for quick reloading. So this is the bolt action right here. The bolt action is so sleek, it's not even funny. So to cock this gun, you gotta push the bolt up and then pull this bolt back. Very smooth. And then push it forward and then push it down. So yeah. This gun is pretty quiet too. The bipod comes with a really nice bipod, full metal bipod. So to extend the bipod, you gotta press this switch right here, shaped like a button. So you push it upwards and you just extend that leg down and do the same thing for the other leg. It's pretty simple. And then you got some extended feet right here. You got these little metal ovals right here. And you can twist it and extend. Is really nice. The hop up is located right here, right next to the barrel. Right now it's on normal, and if you flip it back, it's on hop. And this gun, in my opinion, doesn't need a hop up. It shoots completely straight, so you don't need hop up really. It has a front sling mount right here. which is metal. Whoa. Shit. that wasn't loaded. It has a metal tactical rail right here. You can put the bipod on. The bipod is really easy to get on. So, this is the orange tip right here. Pretty small orange tip. So, yeah, this gun has an FPS of around 500 .20s, 410 of .25s, and 350 of .30s. I highly recommend using .30 gram BBs. This gun is complete shit with .25s and .20s. It shoots way up. It just shoots everywhere. I'm having a bit of an issue with this gun. For some reason, it keeps shooting, I have to aim down and to the left no matter what. I took off my scope, and that's just how the gun shoots. So it's still really accurate if you aim like that, but I would like to aim where the crosshairs are. So if you guys do know what the problem is, please leave a comment. But this thing has a range of probably around 250 feet. It has, the range on this is insane. The accuracy is really good, but as long as you have to aim all the way down, well, not all the way, you have to aim like 5 feet down and 5 feet to the left. So it might just because it's a brand new gun. I just got this like a week and a half ago. Might have to kick in. So overall, this gun is a beast. Performs great. I paid around $120 on Amazon. I rate this 9.5 out of 10 just because of that problem. The up and left, I'll probably down and left, I'll probably like figure it out sooner or later. So yeah, stay tuned for shooting test and comment, rate, and subscribe. Sorry about the review being redone. Turn down for what?